So where did it all begin? Well, the day was July 9th. The trio adventure with two guys you might have heard of, Frost and Blooprint. It was going to be a truly special day, but despite all our attempts
Stevie, what is this, Hotel Transylvania?
What?
Frost, put something hype on. We got to get the people excited.
Dude, I'm setting the tone. There's nothing wrong with some spooky music.
Here we go.
This is... Okay, whatever. I'll roll with it. No, seriously, there's a lot more to this story than meets the eye. Like many of my rest adventures, it does begin slow, but after a while a switch is flipped and things start picking up very rapidly. So pretty much I suggest, of course, you guys watch it throughout, because the later in the video it gets, the more entertaining it becomes. And with all of that being said, my name's Stevie. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the video.
KG Supreme with a tier 1 as well. Thank you so much, man. Alright guys, well, without further ado, I suppose we should get right into it.
So I'm going to cut the audio out here because Blue started playing a trailer that I made for the trio on that day, but it had DMCA music and I don't want to get a copyright strike, so that's why it's muted. But if you want to watch it, I'll have it linked below. It was a little montage cinematic thing to hype people up.
Alright! Alright, let's get this Yo, Stevie, good work, man. Good work. You love to see it, man. High expectations for today. Very optimistic about today. I respect it, Stevie. You know, I, on the other hand, am not. But hopefully today is going to be a good day. Hopefully he's going to prove me wrong and it's going to go insane. Hopefully no stream snipers. Hopefully it's going to be fun. And, yeah, let's get into this shit, baby.
What's going on, everybody? How are you guys doing? Cheers, chat, to the Stevie Blueprint Frost Trio. Boom, we're in. No face cam today, Sag, but I'll still have a great time chilling with you guys, because who knows if this is good content.
Yo, yo, yo. Are we live? All right, well, let's get started. Where and how everyone in Rust begins. As a naked on the beach.
So yeah, like I said, the day was July 9th. It was me, Frost, and Blueprint playing Trio on a vanilla server. To be exact, it was Rusticated US Medium. There were 400 people in the server and it had wiped the previous day. Now, let me pause it real quick. There are going to be moments throughout the video where you notice these weird little blocky, square, blurry thingies on the screen. That has nothing to do with the resolution of the video. That's because a lot of the POVs that I use, the footage from this day, is taken from stream VODs, which have a significantly lower bitrate than normal recordings. So it's a bitrate problem, but there's nothing I can really do about it. So hopefully it isn't too annoying. Anyways, to get to the story. We didn't really have any plans for this day. Now, the reason Blueprint wasn't so optimistic is because with all three of us streaming, it was going to be very, very difficult to have a good, genuine adventure without getting stream sniped.
Welcome to Rust.
Welcome to Rust. All right, now that we have Blueprints intro, what is Stevie's? Stevie's is where does he go?
This is quite the intense story, so what I do recommend is that you sit back, relax, and enjoy the video.
You didn't have to do me like that. But anyways, you'll be able to know whose POV you're watching, who you're watching, because, you know, for me, I'll be in the top left. Frost's POV has a little purple bar in the bottom right-hand corner, which is his sub-goal or sub-count or something, and Blueprint has that big blue banner at the top. Although, pretty soon you'll find out that I end my stream early and just end up recording the rest of it, and I'll explain that in a bit. But long story short, that's how you know who you're watching. And although I'm commentating this, I'm telling the story, it's on my channel, I'm going to be using a ton of both Frost's and Blue's POV. It'll help you guys really understand how we work together in fights and not miss out on any of the action. Also, maybe to make it less complicated, just when I switch to everyone's POV, I'll put their name in the top left-hand corner.
I was behind you. Yo, what's up, dude?
Hey, man.
You on a team or I invited you? Okay, nice.
Yeah. No.
Who's that? Chopping down trees.
I don't know.
He's that hatchet.
Here, I'll distract.
Hit shot him. Hit him again.
Never mind, I don't need to distract.
Dance on him, dude.
He's got a nail gun. Damn, that's toxic, bro. Where's this hatchet?
Oh, right
above
us.
People coming! Oh, we're fucking dead.
I'm dead. Oh my god, they all got nailed.
Oh no, oh no, oh no. Oh god, it's the boys.
Damn, I wish I had that bow kid.
One dead.
You got this, Blue.
Oh, it's Blue.
Come to me, Stevie. You can pick up my bow on my body. I'm on the line at W.
Hit him with a spear!
Okay.
Get him, Blue! He's dead!
You got him!
Let's go!
You're insane!
Come pick me up! Kaka!
Oh my god, that spear toss
was insane.
This is me.
I'm inviting.
Is this you?
Where are you? Yo, what's up?
What's yo, good? Yo.
Where's this Revy?
Alright, let's get out of here. Wait, does someone have a nail gun? They need that nail body. Gun ammo?
Yeah. I can give you that. A nail gun.
Are you Margarita or Nada?
Yeah, Margarita.
Okay, okay, here. There's 11.
Okay. Here, take. Where this, Stevie?
Give him what
that is. This, and then here, take this nail gun.
Thank you. And we're rolling, baby.
Someone's building! Bottom left, stone base!
Need my spear. I got it.
Someone shoot the roof if he tries to place.
Let's push.
He's not placing it.
I see. It's a guy. It's a guy with shit, so watch out.
Okay, we got no guns. We win.
I'll boost someone over.
He's speaking. They know.
No! He's got Python?
No! I'll boost someone. Here, I'll meet him.
I'm pushing close.
You're doing it. Headshot dead.
Nice.
Yo, get him! I mean, headshot him with a spear!
Woo!
He might be dead.
Boost me. Wait, I shot the roof. How is it not up? How is it?
I know. It was weird that they upgraded that. I saw you shoot that.
I'm making a TC.
I can boost you.
No way.
Someone, I'll put on the
what
kid,
did
I guess.
I have, or was he inside?
No, yeah, put on his kid.
Was inside. No, I killed.
Oh, someone's outside. Hello, someone's man. Outside.
Hello, man.
Oh man, you suck, man. Give me loot, man. You suck, ball.
On me. Bro. He's got a water pipe.
I told you.
Nice.
One dead,
one.
He's dead. Other dead. Are you down or dead?
I can give someone down.
Oh my god.
Pichu!
Watch out. He's opening door, I think.
I'm dead.
Oh no.
Hi.
Hey. I'm low HP. You're up. Here, take rev.
Thank you. I'm reloading. Thank you.
I'm dead.
Revo guy's pushing.
I'm dead.
F- So an exciting and chaotic start. Some nice plays from Blue to get us rolling, but we were now all dead. Blue and Frost actually ran back, and with some more nice plays, we're able to get some extra gear from guys that were still lingering around the scene of the fight. Now, here's a map of the server we were playing on. This was all happening in the bottom right-hand corner near Junkyard, but after Blue and Frost got that extra gear, they started running north. We wanted to put a base down near Train Yard and Airfield. It looked like a nice little area. And while they were doing that, I was trying to fix a problem with my stream. You see, the reason Rust isn't streamed that much is because stream sniping on the game is about 10 times more potent than any other game. All someone has to do is see the map that you're on, and they can find out what server you're playing on, and they can use that to door camp you, to raid you, to do anything that they really want. That information is invaluable. So when people do stream Rust, and it's not on a private server like OTP, or something, they use a map cover. Like this, like this, like this. But there was a problem with my map cover. When I released the map button for a split second, the real map would show and not the overlay. It was hardly noticeable, but someone with ill intentions could just take a freeze frame of the map and try to use that to hunt us down and gain that unfair advantage. Now, I tried to fix it for a while, but I was using Streamlabs OBS, and both Frost and Blue were using OBS Studio. OBS Studio allows plugins that can fix a problem like that. Streamlabs OBS does not. So there was pretty much nothing I could do. While I was troubleshooting, Blue and Frost ran north and set a base down exactly where we wanted to, beside the road near Train Yard. Sadly, the base was just a boring 2x2, but I didn't have much input in the design because I wasn't really there, so it would do. I sat in the base for a while, continuing to try to figure out my stream problem, but nothing worked. I realized I just needed to end my stream. It just wasn't worth risking the entire adventure the entire day because I wanted to stream it. I'm not much of a streamer anyways. And so unfortunately, I ended the stream, but I continued recording the adventure. So now my POV doesn't have me in the top left-hand corner. It just has nothing on the screen, kind of like normal. Looks like Frost's, except without the little purple bar. Now, before we keep moving forwards, I'm going to take us back a little bit, because I was trying to figure out my stream thing for a long while, and Blue and Frost kind of accomplished a lot in that time span, so I'll quickly breeze through everything they did while I wasn't there. Back.
Killed him. GG. That's been my code for the past 3 years.
We need to change the code.
No, but we actually, there's someone under our foundation. I literally just saw his name. Look at him.
Yay.
He dead.
Oh, even.
That was a nice scientist.
What do you have?
Supply signal.
You're lying.
No.
Yes, you are.
No. Supply signal.
You can't get supply signals from them.
Just like GIF is pronounced JIF?
Okay. That's it! I'm looking it up! I'm done! It is pronounced JIF, not GIF! That's right, baby! Let's go!
Survey, only 70% of people said GIF. And the format's creator, Steve Wilhite, it's pronounced JIF, not GIF.
Yeah!
He's shooting at me, shooting at me.
Headshot him! Wow, he's insane. He's headshot though. 1 HP.
It's like click, 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 click! Holy sh!
Tomorrow,
okay, I'm gonna call
is
this
the
in.
Official start of our journey.
Yes. When we get this airdrop, dude, that's what I'm talking about.
Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about, baby.
So yeah, while I was trying to figure some things out, Blue and Frost got a decent little start going for us, and they'd thrown that airdrop that Frost got inside of Train Yard.
We back, baby.
Hello, gamers.
Hello.
I'm gonna go see if someone's outside.
Okay. We don't even have enough resources to make...
Oh, it's snowing here a little
something.
Bit. Who threw the airdrop, by the way?
I did.
Can we defend that?
I don't know, we just wanted to do it in the middle of the night.
Makes sense, I suppose.
But no, we literally can't defend it.
I was like looking in the boxes like we got some new guns or something. And we're poverty.
It's coming down right now.
Hey.
Come on.
Showtime, baby.
A spaz 12 and a bunch of grenades. That's what we have to show for it.
Get me in! See ya! Please turn off your torch, man. We're dead. This is terrible. No stone, no nothing.
We're fine. We're fine.
Bro, we can f*** those guys.
Yo, there's a combo right here. Someone take it.
Me.
Top right box.
Take the stone spear, Frost. No.
Psych. I'm gonna go
take that.
Frick
that.
Them up.
Let's go, let's go.
Go.
Headshot hit, he's one health!
Ooh,
Tommy's one HP!
Headshot.
Tommy dead?
Get him!
Grenade out!
Come up with the grenade!
Wait, he has endless bullets. He has a fucking drum mag in his Thompson, I'm dead.
I hit him?
You got him!
Hit him again?
Wait, never mind, he's just sitting there!
I hit him twice! Get a gun!
I don't know where one is!
Hit him with a rock!
I'm doing it! Hit him!
Okay, he has endless health. Endless fucking health.
Where'd he just go?
In the base. He lives there.
Wait, did he pick up the gun, though?
The roof.
I don't think he got my spaz, but... There's no way that he ran over and picked up my spaz, did he? I got my spaz, but he got my ammo. Unless there's someone else.
I have your ammo. Come to me, bro. Come.
I'm here.
Take this. Good gear.
Fuck. Where's the ammo? Oh, you got dropped it.
We killed one though, right?
Yeah, but he grabbed his gun.
Son of a...
Oh, shit. Two guys behind. Oh, okay.
I hit, like half charged him, but I'm dead.
Oh, no.
Massive timers.
How low did I get him with that headshot?
He's dead. Hazmat behind the base.
What? Go for it.
He's looting it. It's just one guy with a crossbow. He's running away with everything. He's right here.
You're a gamer.
Oh my god, dude.
He's dead.
Thank you.
Oh my god, yes. We need this. We need this so bad. I'm running in base.
Good.
Stonked. It's literally like a row of crossbows, dude.
Good work. Stonked.
Oh my god, crossbows! I made it in with crossbows!
I'll spawn in 2 minutes. I have a timer.
Meanwhile, I'll make friends on the beach. So like I said, I spawned on the beach just waiting for my bag timer, but we were now in a pretty interesting situation because we had some next door neighbors that lived super close and it was pretty clear what they were trying to do. They were chainsawing down the forest to make a compound. I would do the same if I were them, if I lived so close to another group. But of course, they would need a ton of wood to do so, which would give us a couple more tries to kill them while they were chopping wood, despite them having better guns than us. When I spawned back in, the plan was simple. We did want to make our base stone because there was a chance they could flame raid it at the moment and we really didn't have anything to defend ourselves. I emptied out some of the revolvers we had in the boxes and filled all the bullets into the P2, just enough for one mag and a couple extra shots, and then we ran to the snow to farm.
Okay.
All right.
Frost should go first. I nominate Frost.
Yep.
You don't have a gun.
Go. One dead. Extra crossy. Gimme.
God Trio is still prim. Chat,
we literally agreed upon ourselves to play at your guys' pace so you guys can have a better, like, grasp
true.
Of
the game.
We're not going too hard, just, you know, it's a little bit
we're
more
we're literally
fun
all playing 5%
guys.
Effort. I'm
yeah, not yeah, 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 yeah.
So Blue went down into a cave that we found in the snow to try to find some stone, and we didn't find too much, but enough to make some decent upgrades. But then, our neighbors were back outside, chopping trees.
Dude, they're chopping trees again, right up front.
With chainsaw?
I missed.
Yes, actually, with chainsaw. Hold on, I have PJ. I can go above him. I have 8 shots.
No. He's already running.
He'll come back.
He's holding his base. They're both on their base. They don't want none of this smoke.
Hold on, I'm going to crouch up. Do you guys near me, Frost? I don't think it's them. They're crouching up to that base. There's about to be a fight. They're getting door camped.
Now, a fight never broke out. Our neighbors never left their base, so the door campers never actually fought them, and the guys that were outside their base door camping snuck away before we could sneak up on them. So, pretty much nothing happened. But we realized even if a fight did break out, we weren't really ready for it. We didn't have that much to work with. Blue upgraded half of our base to stone, but our doors were still wood. We needed some resources bad. And so, we decided we would run over to Airfield, our goal being to get some metal fragments to make metal doors. But more importantly, we needed scrap. We wanted to research pistol ammo. If we could do that, we could craft a bunch of it, and we had a few pistols to work with. And so, we set out.
So, we'll actually be okay if we research pistol ammo.
Yeah,
guns.
I think we can run up the snow towards Oxum's U16 and recycle what we get, and we'll have enough to come back and make a research and research pistol. There's a guy chopping wood up to my right.
Ooh, AK to our left.
He's right here, chopping this tree. Hit him. Nice. Damn. Metal pick.
That's really nice, yeah.
Hit all these barrels here.
Yeah, I know, nice.
We don't talk about it. You were just trying to throw it over. Yeah.
Guy in here with a pistol.
What? I see him. Yeah, he's behind the truck.
I missed. Was it a pistol or was it a crossbow?
Nail gun.
It was a pistol. Oh, Satch.
Wow.
Yoing.
Thanks, Margarita.
Absolutely finessed.
Mm-hmm. I got 3 tech trash too, so here you go. Dropped it.
Keep rope, that. And then recycle everything else, I think.
We have like 6 rope at base. And that guy we just killed, he has like 75 scrap.
The more the merrier.
Guy here on me?
In front of the...
Yep.
Hit him. There's two. Tossing a grenade.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh my god,
he's loaded too! 100 scrap!
Let's go.
Let's run back to base! Look at the pipes!
We gotta make it home.
Yeah, we have to.
Right here.
This would be huge.
Huge, dude!
Oh! Are we getting raided?
We're getting
our base. GG.
Do you want me to F1 or no? No, probably not. I'll just die and spawn.
We'll kill him.
No, it's so fast to get the second satchel down.
They're getting jumped. They're getting ambushed.
Oh, they actually are. This is perfect. All right. I'm crafting. Hold on.
Inside. Give me good stuff, Stevie. I'll just rush inside.
No. I mean, they're going to be in. I'm making a wooden door right now and a code lock, okay? I'm going to just try to slap on
the
first
thing. I already did that.
Okay, you already have it? You have them both?
Yep.
Okay, nice. Okay, do you want to take the rest of my good stuff then?
Yes.
Okay.
What? They're in? Shush.
Wait, you're key now, right? What's on roof? He's dead. He just died.
And I hit the crossy guy on the left. I killed the crossy guy on the left, I think. Yeah, he's dead. One more Tommy guy at their base.
I didn't even go through the...
He's pushing up. I hit Tommy guy. Tommy guy out front.
Okay, let me depot.
He's running back.
Oh my god, dude. I'm instantly dead. He's at the front door. At the front door?
Yeah. I have someone from my P2, give me a sec. Frost, there's a body out here you can loot. If you spawn in some outside.
I'll spawn outside.
Dude, you took the hammer outside, you f***!
Give me comps,
I need to make
comps.
A new one!
Upgraded, we're good. Nice. Good shit. I'm coming.
Killed Revo.
Where's body?
It's over here. It's where you just heard P2 shots on the ledge.
Alright, there's a guy right beside me with a crossbow.
Kill Tommy. Tommy
left.
Dead.
Nice. Good shit. Guy on your left by the PC.
Nice blue. I'm covering. You can loot if you want.
Where's body? You see me?
Up to the right on the ledge.
I'm going.
Just go through the trees a bit. You'll see it.
Wasn't this
Watch
guy
out,
holding
a
gun?
There's a crossbow dude coming from their base.
Okay.
I see it. He's shooting at you?
I see him. He's running back, I think. I'm looting this body loaded. Oh, this
nice,
was...
Good shit.
Okay, I'm getting...
Cross.
Yeah.
I'm low, I'm just gonna run out with nothing.
Yeah, do it. I'm gonna go... Did you clear that full top body with the Revo and everything, Frost?
I cleared, yeah, pretty much all the weapons are gone. There's a sword out there.
Okay.
That's it.
We got two Tommies and a SAR.
I'm making a research bench so we could learn a pistol bolt.
Perfect.
We have enough for that? We hopefully should. Let me see.
Yeah, we do.
We need 200 metal frags. We have...
Oh, frags, right.
We need 26. What's in there?
6. Okay, we'll just wait a bit.
We need 5 more.
And so we waited for the metal frags to make a research table so that we could research pistol ammo like we had planned. And in hindsight, maybe it was a good thing that we didn't upgrade our base so fast, because that baited our neighbors to raid us. Seemed like they were pretty mad after this fight, and they started coming through our roof. Now, the reason they didn't go through our doors, I'm not quite sure. Maybe the skin of the doors made them think it was an armored or metal door? I don't really know, but they decided to go through the wooden roof, which took a little bit of extra time, so they never actually made it inside of our base by the time we had killed them all. And that raid defense was the break that we needed, because things had been going pretty slow, but now we had a few guns, now we had pistol ammo researched, now was when things would start to pick up.
That's not us, SAR, right?
No. We should push out
for
all full HP to get
SAR.
That. We have Tommies now? Here, I'm gonna grab a Tommy.
The Tommies don't have ammo, you have to unload.
I'm good. I'm emptying my P2. I'll have like a mag
I'll just
and a
wait.
Half.
I have a revolver.
Yeah, whoever goes first, I'll just trade.
Alright, you ready?
Wait. Let's go. He's dead.
Oh my god, what a piece of shit.
We're sorry.
He's behind base. Oh, headshot him! Behind this base, right here. 2x1.
Pushing. He's running. He got beneath the ridge, no way. I think he's going on the rock to the right, maybe? No, he's not. He's over here. Twice? 3 times?
He went in.
Where?
No, the door's open. I don't think he's alive.
Yeah, but he can close it. He can close it, so he's gotta be alive.
Wait, why is he not closing it?
I don't know. Hey?
Maybe he doesn't know.
Yeah, he's inside.
Oh, maybe he forgot.
Wait. Okay, it's
oh
a
my
thing.
God, dude.
What a cringe. Oh it's a, literally, you can
headshot
maybe
that,
hit Tommy.
Watch out.
Okay.
What were we thinking there, boys?
I didn't think it reaches that far up. That's insane. I thought I could jump past it. You got my body,
snow.
Right? Frost?
No, I can't get your
you can't,
body.
You can't reach that from there?
you jumped across the fucking box, dude. Your body's...
So with a combined nearly 12,000 hours of game time, both Blueprint and I had died to a trap base. And almost worse than the fact that a bunch of people were watching it happen live on stream, was the fact that we had now lost two of our best guns, a SAR and a Tommy. Did we go back and do a little bit of door camping out of spite? Absolutely. Did they ever come out? No, our guns were gone. And so we decided to use our last Tommy to protect us as we ran to airfield with all of the recyclables we had been collecting so far this wipe. Maybe after we recycled, a nice little boost in resources would boost our morale.
We just gotta pray we don't lose this Tommy so we
can
research
it. Here
you
go, 88 bullets for your Tommy.
88.
Should I take a pistol?
Thank you.
Yeah, I need a pistol too.
We kind of got to send it here.
Zero bullets.
Oh, I can give you some of this ammo. I don't need all this.
No, I have a pistol. I just need ammo, I meant.
That's what I'm saying. Okay. There's
give
15
a little bit. I'm making
for
a little bit extra for
There's
us.
15 for you.
I have 60 extra. I'm kind of chilling.
We should really think about getting a sheet metal door on our base eventually.
We look less threatening now.
Do we have all the grind on us?
Yeah, I got it all.
Stevie does.
All right, so let's just not die, and we win. I want to go to that. We have guns now. Okay, maybe not. I'm going to drop this off, and we go.
Winnable.
He's right in front
of me. I see him.
They're across our... They're on our side. I'm going to the right.
There's a guy crouching on me.
Okay, I'm instantly killed. Those guys are fucking crazy at the game.
Two nakeds behind me. Give me a second. Dude, these nakeds are going to ruin my life. These guys are just... Dude, they're both Yokas.
How did I just get hit?
Did you get hit by a Tommy?
I got hit. Yeah.
That was hip fire.
Me here. Me.
Okay.
They just ran, I guess. Oh, no, they're on the rock. They're on the rock. I mean, I can't. And there's another. They're going to push me. They're going to push me. There's naked here?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, he's getting Tommy from behind.
They're pinned. Hey, that guy was... That guy close.
Hit him, dead. Tommy on the ground.
Dead. Nice, he's dead.
I got Tommy. Okay, nice. I'm going to use your med kit, sorry.
The far guy's hit twice as well. You can use it.
Should I loot your body fully?
Yeah, you can. I'll come get it.
I just don't want to grab getting it.
Worry about that third party on the other side.
I'm going near you. What are you doing, dude?
Shut the f... Hit him. Did I just down him?
He might have.
No shot.
Where was this first far guy? Guy above?
Maybe I didn't die.
He had sorry.
Come on!
Guy on me. He's dead.
Getting bowed, hog. You want your Tommy back?
I don't have any health right now.
Here, take a med. Bandages.
Let's get back really quick. We gotta learn these.
So did we get the Tommy guy from behind, or did he run and then we killed the SAR guys?
I don't know. We killed two SAR guys. We have two SAR kits, but...
Okay. Now we recycle with these kits. Easy.
You want to learn a SAR?
Give it a blow. I met. The fight was a success. We got back two guns, kind of exactly what we lost from the trap base, and per our plans before the fight, we grabbed all of the components and ran over to airfield to do some recycling. All right, we ready to go? Wait, I need a bit extra pistol ammo.
Blue, throw your SAR in there, man.
Why?
So we can learn it.
Why am I the one that puts the SAR in?
Can you make this frost?
Killed the guys with
on the ground.
Yeah, but we don't have a tier 2 yet. I'm going to be going to fucking mining.
Yeah, but we're
going to
get a tier 2 right now. Wait, okay, what happened to your P2? Let's... What are you giving me? I just depot. Oh, here, 16 pistol bullets.
All right, let's go. We got things to do. Sorry. Oh.
Oh, my. There's a crate here, you guys.
Wait, maybe we reroute to Oxum's.
Yeah. Because
we have all of our recyclables on us. But then there's that big, massive... juicy thick boy to the left.
Or we can just take the fat dub and chad the fuck up and make plays.
I think we'll be
we can come in and recycle here and just leave without ever fighting. There's
okay, I'm running.
Oh my god,
it's really good. I'm going first. Oh my,
bro. Stevie,
jump.
Good, bro. You putting on a little pounds, a few pounds, man?
No, man, no. All I eat is fruit, I swear. Green crate.
It's true.
Python, baby. Let's go.
Man, it takes like a picture. It's all like dark and there's like some grapes and watermelon.
All right. Just if anyone comes over here, I'm yoinking this stuff and running because it's a lot. So we discreetly recycled everything we had, with no problems at all. The fight on the other side of the airfield never shifted in our direction. Well, to be fair, there was an MP5 guy that was sneaking in our side, but Blue got him. However, a few minutes later, as we were leaving out the back...
Bro, you didn't...
This guy on a headshot on a horse right there!
Three times? I mean, twice? Three times? Headshot?
Again?
Dead?
He's gone, all dead. Dude.
Yeah, two guys. 220.
Three guys!
Yeah, three.
Hit one twice? Hit him again. That
one
guy.
Once.
Hit him again.
Twice. Down. Back guy.
No.
Nice. Good shit.
Guy.
Then I'm coming up here. Is there one still alive?
Yeah.
Headshot him. AK. 2x2.
MP5's touch on it! Again, down!
Nice.
He walled,
yeah.
Push this. I have Tommy. I meant to hit right. You're gonna drop this off in a bush. Give me a sec.
Hit one.
I'm gonna med.
Yeah, drop it off in a bush.
There's still two alive. He picked his, picked his buddy up.
Yeah. I didn't mean to hit inventory.
AK's up top. And once, twice.
I don't know if we have the advantage anymore. Maybe we should dip. I'm running low on ammo too.
Time to go snake.
AK's ditching.
I shot it.
MP5, 1 HP, if not dead.
Okay.
He's behind the wall still.
Yeah, I see.
Behind the wall, standing hill.
You chatted him.
He's dead.
Good shit.
Nice. Oh my god, he doesn't
hold
down.
I can his body.
All right, okay. Watch out. AK guy flanking above.
Yeah, you go for this one. I'll leave it. He's got so much.
Yeah, watch out.
AK guy. Hit him once. 250. Wait, they live at a circle base up there.
That's the one. You good?
I have so much. We need to go, Frost.
I need to go loot my body here.
Right on. I'm gonna get my stuff and start running.
Oh, here it is.
All right, shit.
Yeah, this is gonna blow.
Yo, good to get out. I
think. Yeah.
Just
you looted that guy.
Okay, we're good.
I need some of that 5.5 frost.
Yeah, I'll give you some. All right, we'll take it. We got everything except the AK kit.
Dude, I have extra I have two extra SARS, MP5, and Tommy.
Nice shoe. I pretty much have 500 scrap for tier 2.
Yeah, I have two SARS and an MP5 on me, so nice.
Those guys like wiped the people at airfield and were like leaving with the kits. That's what they were doing.
Good shots, Blue. Holy shit. That back guy was fucking... He got dropped. That was far too.
Dude, I bet that AK guy had like no meds left, man.
Yeah, I know. That was kind of sad that he made it up there. If he didn't have a wall right there, he was just dead. Like, he was just so dead, but he didn't.
100%, yeah.
Let's go, baby.
I'm gonna leave MP5 hollow if anyone else wants to go with it. I'm gonna go out star again.
The run was a smashing success. Keep in mind, we had very few guns at this point, so if we had died at airfield with all of our components and most of our guns, we would have very little to fall back on. But no worries about that, because with some nice shots from me, Blue, and Frost, we were able to come up big time. And now, after making a tier 2 workbench, researching some stuff, making some meds and ammo, it seemed like a good time to start upgrading the base. But Blueprint had the building plan and the hammer, and we know how that can turn out.
Do we have a hammer or no hammer? We have no hammer.
No hammer, man. Oh, I'm using it.
Wait.
Can I help you? Stevie, I'm not gonna hear it. I'm not gonna hear it.
No, Pancake Layer, are you yoking me, man?
Oh my god.
We would have won the Coco Raid defense had we had a full-fledged Pancake Layer, I swear.
They didn't even go through the roof.
They went through this up. They went through the side and they broke into the first two floors.
Exactly. That's called
Blue.
Honeycomb. And guess
what?
Oh,
that's
something you're perfectly
you're
capable
not
of doing yourself.
Buddy.
I won't even try to explain. It's not worth it. We have tier 2 down.
As many of you know, I'm a huge fan of the pancake layer, which is a building technique. I'm not really going to explain it all now because my next video is going to talk about it a lot. But if you're curious what I meant when I talked about the coconut bee raid defense, I can take a little aside and explain that to you. If you want to skip past it, you can, but it includes me and Blue, and it's an online raid defense. Rewind a few days from this date, June 9th. Earlier in the week, Blueprint and I were playing on the OTV server together, with Shaki and Nora as our teammates. Essentially, the OTV server is a private server with a bunch of content creators playing Rust together, or playing Rust against each other. So again, on that server, Blueprint was the one that built the base. He had a bunker design that he wanted to try out, and so he built it. No pancake layer was included. Now, fast forward a couple of days, Nora got a bit mad that Coconut B ran her over. I'll play the clip.
Hello? Wait, who's this? Hello? Stop. Coco! Stop! Coco, I swear to God, if you do that again... Coco, I swear to God I will steal more of your skins. I swear to God. Do it! Do it! I swear to God I will...
Oh,
So enraged, Nora ran back over to Coconut Bee's base with a rocket launcher against better judgment and killed Coconut Bee by blowing him up and his car. Not but 30 minutes later, Coconut Bee and 7 teammates, including Hutnik and Deathwing, who probably have like 70,000 hours of Rust combined, ran over to our base, made a raid base, and started raiding us. I'll play my POV from the defense.
What the? Gonna be on pause.
What? Are we getting raided?
Attention, Nora! We are... Nora's a loser!
Okay.
Fine. We'll leave that closed for now. We need people to flood in.
Let me get my gun.
Stevie?
I'm not ready yet. Hold on.
Yep, it's me.
This is nothing against you. It's Nora.
Hi, Stevie.
Guys, I'm friendly.
Jelly, nice to see you. Nora blew up my fucking car.
Village! Here, Stevie.
Open the door, Nora.
Over here! They're in here! They're in here! Watch to the side, they're in here.
They're coming out.
Keep cutting, Coco.
I'm gonna open it up.
Don't think.
Also, if you're curious why it's so loud what that music is, we made a dance floor in our base that was hooked up to the same electricity system as our turrets, so we had to have the music on for the turrets to be on. Also, the reason everyone's talking in game is because Discord wasn't allowed.
No way. Holy crap.
So although I kept fighting, we lost the raid. They had run away with all of the loot, and they were just coming back and forth and back and forth, transferring everything. They'd gotten to the core. Blueprint and Shaki weren't on at the time of the raid, so essentially it was a 7 or 8v2. But how this event relates to a pancake layer is you can see right here after I was sealing, once they had taken everything from our core, that they blew into the first and second story of the base. We had a ton of loot on both floors, so if there was a pancake layer out in the honeycomb, pretty much they couldn't have blown into both stories of the base. It's kind of hard to explain, but like I said, I'm gonna talk about it a lot in my next video. Just know that pancake layers are very good and should be in every single Rust-based design, pretty much. But time to get back to the story, because things were about to start moving very fast.
Don't let the food burn, by the way. Someone can take it out, please.
Oh, we have 500 scrap. We're rich as... We're not gonna need tier 3. That's unnecessary. So let's learn everything. What are we missing?
Everything? We can learn a ladder.
All right, don't know wall. That's fine.
You were muted.
Yeah,
I wasn't.
You actually were muted, sir.
Yep.
Nope. Can someone watch the campfire?
Oh no, you did say that.
You did say that. Yeah. It's okay. We're watching the campfire.
I thought Frost had it, to be honest. So.
All right, you guys want to all get on a first name basis here?
No, not. No.
Wait, can we call you by your full name? Oh, wait.
Stevie's real name, though.
Wait.
I have both of your names and addresses. Don't say shit.
Whoa, oh, what shit. The fuck?
I'm just saying.
No, I'll say whatever the hell I want. You ain't gonna fight me.
The next morning, we heard some shots over in the train yard direction, and we decided to run over there.
Base here. Double dead, Sar. Double dead.
Just headshot.
Yeah, I finished him.
You got two?
The door. Loot that guy in the door.
Hold on.
Is this the trap base?
I'm gonna go to the door and close it. Alright, I killed him.
Okay.
You getting jumped?
No, it's just a bow kid.
Okay, got both swords. Something. Spear.
Hazmat behind this base. Right behind this base. Hazmat.
Okay. I'm holding right.
I completely whipped.
Two.
I'm sorry.
Headshot one. Might be dead. Okay. I'm low. Backing up.
Wow, I just got double beamed. Fuck me.
Dead? There's still two behind the base, though, I think.
Yeah, they ran back on the road. They were, like, giving each other loot.
Oh, shit.
Did they loot me? Is that one?
Maybe, I don't know. I died, though, on the other side of the road.
There's a SAR on the ground. You got it? Be careful, they're to the right, behind a tree.
Yeah, one hazmat looting my body on the other side of the road.
Okay.
I downed one.
Oh, kill the other.
Nice. I'm pulled down.
Yeah, they're both dead.
Watch out, Nick's running up my body. Yeah, loot me.
Hope Nick is dead.
Try, yeah. I got a med, though.
Hey. They're loaded.
I think they're playing fucking Tarkov. They just crouched up the trees.
Did you check out the space yet, or is that a... No.
Just come cover me. Come cover me. There's a ton here.
Got a star on the ground. I think that was the one that you were talking about that you missed.
Maybe. Could be.
Just me here.
The guy that Frost killed might have had a gun on the ground as well. I have a bunch extra, but let's just go. Let's just go.
I have Tommy and two extra stars, so I have three stars total.
Okay, yeah, let's
you
get
fully
out of here.
Loot me,
let's
get out of here. Blue?
Yes, I got it all.
It's a great day to be alive. You know, the sun won't shine when I. Oh! Source!
Oh my god, I need meds. I only have one. I don't think Frost has any.
I can craft. Did you learn them, Frost?
I did learn them, but we don't have any low grade.
Oh, that's a problem.
I think bandages.
I can give each of you one. I have four.
Okay.
Here, take this. One on the ground there, and then one on the ground for you.
We need low grade.
We should do cards too and do oil maybe.
Yeah, I agree.
Large rig right below us.
You have two barricades, right, Blue, or Frost?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
I don't have two, but it's okay. I think Blue loot in mine.
I can give one. Hit it twice. I shot him, hit him, I doubled him. Dead.
No, I'm dead. Hit him once.
Kill close guy.
I'm down.
Make it dead looting, AK.
Nice.
MP5 on the rod to the right. We can push to that with barricades if you guys come with me.
Yeah, I'm going to try to distract him on the right. You try to get to that.
Yeah, I'm trying. Can you come with me, Blue?
Yeah.
I have two barricades to get there. Naked going back. Hit twice, dead.
Once.
I barricaded.
Huge.
I have three walls.
Yeah, nice.
I don't have the AK set. I don't know.
Nick had probably looted it.
I'm just baiting.
I walled. I have AK. Or no. I have this set, but no AK. Just cover. Did he have in his hands? I got it.
Yeah, he did 100%.
Alright.
My game just froze.
He's beaming. I'm down.
Hello?
Again.
What the f was that?
One hit three times.
Just go through his head.
Who's down? I can get you.
I'm
down
right here.
I have two walls still, so we're chilling. I can give you meds and everything.
Nice, sweet.
I'm picking you up with a med.
Dude, that takes forever. What?
Yeah, it's a long
time. Back up, bro.
Yeah.
Get behind this. Take this. Take that barricade.
A little bit more 5.5.2 if you have any.
Yeah, I got. Dead. He's dead.
Nice.
I just toggled, dude. Sorry, I was my scripts weren't working.
Wait. Hit twice. He's running behind that rock, straight 140.
Yeah, that was pretty huge. I see. Has he? Twice.
Hit him. Dead. Nice.
Yeah. So, get back to base.
Yeah.
So, what did you want to do? Hit barrels for crude.
a good idea, actually.
And there you go. Our first AK of the wipe. Of course, we planned to go out and roam with it. I gave it to Blueprint because it was his kill, so therefore it's his kit. And with the goal now of getting some low-grade fuel by smelting our crude oil, we ran over with our kits to Train Yard.
You guys ever get the problem where when you eat cantaloupe, it makes the roof of your mouth itch a little bit?
Yeah, sorry, we're not just fruit eaters over here.
I'm just saying.
How, like, hard it is and not juicy.
What do you mean by that?
You know, like, those specific fruits that, like, have those acids that... All right, I'll wait until after this fight.
Yeah, maybe a little bit later.
Yeah, I can't hear, dude. Shush.
Thank you.
Got a crossbeam.
Oh my god, guy in the space.
20 bullets left.
Bust up. Twice. Three times. Dead.
He's down, I think.
One guy right in the trees, in the tree lines, near the trail, the road.
Yeah.
Headshot, body.
I can't even see this guy.
What?
I can't see them. I can't. I thought 1440p would help that, dude. Guess I'm just a blind bat.
1440p is a myth. Hit him. Twice.
Nice.
All right, I'm not done with you yet, motherfucker. You should be dead. Come back.
I'm out of meds, by the way.
This is
I'm just gonna push through
risky.
The cover. I'm getting sprayed by another. Surely that's the same guy.
That is the same guy, yeah. I have a med for you on the ground.
I'm 50 HP.
He got grubbed. Let's go. One dead, naked.
Oh, dead. I'm shooting a phantom.
I'm getting sword from behind. Two.
Yeah, double sword.
12 HP. Meds. I'm getting out of here. I gotta hide blue.
I got meds for you. I got two.
Come. Come on. Yes, bad.
They're both on me, and they're both prim.
Okay.
They're both prim.
We can win this. I just need time to heal. I have 13, as well. 5-5, bro. If you have any extra for me.
Still looting there. Three. They're shooting right now. Why someone?
Pushing right.
This ain't looking good.
We should get the AK kit like out of there. Like 100%. This is so grubby now.
There's so many, yeah.
We can make it.
Yeah. Oh, I got a med off a scientist. No way.
Nice.
What a swag.
Yeah, they're running away.
Which way? Oh, I see them all.
Yeah, the right
blue, we might have to like pin them here. You can make it.
Yeah. Oh, I got a med off a scientist. No way.
Nice.
What is this lag?
They're like low on meds.
I'm dead. That's fine. I'll be there in a sec. Blue, what's your
AO? I'm pushing that too. Right, I'm almost there. I literally hear it.
One full dead.
Down, nice.
Two dead, three dead. They're all dead.
I'm dead in the back. I'm dead with AK. Random MP5 guy shot me in the back.
I gotta try to loot their bodies before that guy peeks on me.
Yeah, Stevie, try to get a gear set and I'll meet up with you.
Yeah, okay.
Ooh. Up by that base with the twig walls is where MP5 killed me. He's probably just gonna loot and dip. Come. Yeah.
Thank you. Where's that AK guy?
He's gone. He left. It's okay. I'm doing better with SAR anyways. I'm gonna get more kits with a SAR than that thing anyway.
I need help looting over here or finding kit. I'm getting SAR'd, Frost.
Yeah, I see him. I'm dead.
Okay. I'm waiting. I'm just hiding here. Blue, where are you at?
He's got a spacesuit on.
Trying to come back.
Okay.
Just gonna be coming for a sec. I'm gonna try to go back under my shit.
I'm dead. They're two. Fucking A. Once hit three times.
Now, unfortunately, not only had we lost the kits we got from these guys here, but Blueprint had gotten grubbed from behind, and we lost the AK kit as well. But there was a silver lining to all of this, because these turn of events would lead to what we'll call the rock fight. Listen carefully. the guy that killed Blueprint from behind wasn't a solo player. He was actually part of a 3-5 man group, and after they killed Blueprint and got his AK set, they started roaming over to where I died because, you know, there were more shots over there. But there were so many rocks and bases all around that they quickly got overwhelmed by grubs. Pretty much people running out with low amounts of gear, very little risk, and just running to every single fight and respawning and doing it again and again and again. We were kind of contributing to this because we ran over a lot, which you guys will see soon, but the group that had died with Blueprint's AK kit, they weren't happy about it at all. They were clearly from out of town, otherwise they probably wouldn't run over to the rock formation to begin with, but they had rockets, and they wanted to find someone to point their finger at to raid to hopefully get their kits back. So watch as this fight plays out, because it gets pretty chaotic.
I think the SAR guys pulled up on the rocks outside their base. Yeah, they did. They did. They died on the way back to their tower is what I think just happened. And I'm pulling up behind one of these SAR guys.
That dude on top of the rock, are we going to go for him?
I could kill him in a second. There's a guy to the right. Tell me when you're ready.
He's not on my side.
I'm ready to shoot whenever. He's dead. He's dead from AK just in got their chapped. Base. Yeah. I'm going to kill the second guy.
Kill him, right?
To the right. Yeah, 2x2. We need to go, like, fast, kind of.
Behind that furnace.
Oh, he's to the right here. He's right in front of me, I believe.
Oh, that's AK. You killed him. You just killed him.
Another, I think. Blue, I need you. Both dead. I'm getting rocked.
Yep.
Killed naked. Blue, if you get to me, nice we... Job. Oh, there's another guy.
Yeah, Stevie, watch your back from our base. Yeah, Stevie, watch your back from our base.
Kill him.
I thought you were holding shit down.
Here, take ammo on the ground. There's a med, and there's a body 330, and a hazzy on the ground as well. I don't have a gun for you, it's on the body 330. Oh, this guy got back to his AK friend. No, he didn't. I killed him. AK dead. Just
another full kit on me. Two guys.
Now. Hit twice. That naked may be dead. I have no ammo.
No, he's
yeah,
dead.
I did. I called back behind that. My AK is like around.
No, he's one shot. There's an AK on the ground on this side, Frost.
Dead.
Nice. You can rest, maybe. Dude, there's a lot of... Dude, there's so many bodies there. We have to go back. Like... I mean, there's no way we killed as many people as we did and we don't come out on top. Like, that's our fight, you know? Let's get it.
Dude, let's go! It's a fight. 3v3 right now.
There's a naked on the very tip-top rock beside you.
Are you guys fighting this?
They're at that 2x2 base right now.
These, like, beams go across.
They're raiding it! They just sent a rocket into the doorway. Let's push.
Because they think for some reason that those guys live there because they put that sheet metal door on there.
You know, I bet these guys got killed. They think the guys that killed them live in the 2x2. And so that's why they're raiding it. I bet that's what's happening. Right, we should 3-2-1 if anything.
Sorry.
Rocket launch 1 HP.
Twice on that guy zigging.
Yeah. One's beaming with MP5 at the 2x2. I shot hit twice! 1 HP behind the furnace base. I'm keying. So low, dude. But I give my life. Dead. Things changed. I just ran away.
Watch out, that guy's coming.
Oh my god! Roll rockets, I'm leaving! I'm leaving, I'm leaving. I left an MP5, I don't even care. Goodbye.
Guy on me up here? Dead, he's dead. Tommy dead.
Oh, I made it home, dude. Holy shit.
Where are you, Frost? That's what
I'm dead.
One's on this rock above me, I think.
He crawled behind the wall. He's not.
Hey, get dead.
Go underneath the rock.
He comes.
One more. Yeah. Okay, nice.
I'm got AK? I can pick
you. Do you have a med on this guy?
No. Not one. Hold on.
One dead. Four killed one. He's full of them.
There's a guy in this rock above us. Here, take this blue and trade. Oh my god. Can you get to that MP5, buddy?
Yeah, you guys in the furnace space. Dead? One dead? Okay. Three hazmats dead with shit as well. Killed MP5, he's dead. On me, he did wake back up. He's awake. He just finished me.
He's up top.
Son of a bitch. He's gonna peek.
We should try to run, I don't know.
Yeah, this is terrible.
Like,
man.
Just
I
no
had
meds.
I had three walls on my body. Three wood walls.
Okay, I have a stone wall.
We need to come back to this, man. Wow, I just got beamed. I'm down. Insane players.
He's rushing down.
You're up in 3, 2, 1. I'm getting shard.
MP5 pitched me full kit. MP5 is so much better. Yeah,
close, bro. Blue, maybe we do run.
Oh, yeah.
Killed Hazzy, we run.
Did you kill him? Okay.
I killed Hazzy, yeah, but.
Perfect. We're dead right here.
I have one wall, but no priv.
Oh my god, run!
I'm gonna just come help escort you guys back.
No way that fucker gets up. Oh, yeah, nice. Really fun gameplay.
I walled. Okay,
No, you're good here if you pick me up. He's too far. He's literally still over there.
That guy 3 times. Come to me, keep coming.
Fortnite?
This is so scuffed. Can you give me any comms, Frost? Like, do you know where they are?
No, I don't. They're up.
No way! There's one left and one right.
Kill one on your
okay,
right.
Okay, that was the right guy. We're pretty safe now. Just behind.
I'm dead.
We're both dead.
Always on the screen here.
We were so close to being out of there, but the Tommy guy from behind had killed us both, and therefore, we got none of the loot back to our base. Now, we did have the rockets that Blueprint brought back initially, but at this point, because of how much gear we had committed to trying to win that fight, we had very few guns or resources to make meds left in our base. But we had an idea. We had a rocket launcher and some rockets and explosive ammo as well, and it seemed like our next door neighbors had gotten off after they tried to raid us much earlier in the day. So, we planned to raid them back. To return the favor, maybe they would have a bunch of resources, some extra guns, so we could continue to PvP and make back everything that we'd lost. We really didn't have that much gear to protect ourselves with while we were raiding, but their base was so close to ours, we thought we would be safe.
Like one cloth, maybe. Alright, let's go!
Oh my god.
Shut up, Frost! You're ruining my clips! Another sheet door? Okay, this is good. This is actually poggers. I have enough for this one. I have 6 with this one. 6 expo ammo.
Okay, we
armored.
Oh, okay, so just try going through the door. Okay, maybe they left everything open. Who knows?
It's open. Wait, kind of open? Hey, we got some furnaces.
Yoinks.
Oh my god, sulfur?
Go. Alright, we get him out of here.
Stop, dude. We only need three more rockets, dude.
Listen, no one will know what base was getting raided, and we can come back at a later time.
Let's go do oil.
That was the plan. Pretty simple. We were going to go to oil rig to try to get a little more explosives. We just needed three rockets worth, and we would be in the core of our neighbor's base. But before we could even leave our base to head over to oil rig, there were a bunch of footsteps outside. As night was approaching, it was pretty apparent that these guys had run over to try to counter the raid that we were just doing.
Let's just hope they don't log back on.
What's the best way for us to get cloth and low grade safely in a lot?
Cloth is tunnels, low grade, farming barrel.
You want to take that?
Do you have SAR ammo, please?
I do. I'm ready.
I need some. Give me some, please.
Oh, here. I dropped you some.
Where?
On the way out.
I got it. 14 bullets. That's all I need.
Do you see them?
Yeah, one's up right here. Right behind
this. Let
them
get close, maybe? Okay, yeah.
Killed SAR behind. I thought that was us. I'm actually, I kind of have to loot that.
He's going.
Come to the left so he doesn't see you through the
That's up.
I'm out. So he doesn't see
you. That's up.
I'm out.
I'm getting silenced something in the. I'm in our honeycomb right now and just like chilling.
That's cute. That's cute.
I'm in our honeycomb right now and just like chilling.
That's cute. That's cute, Candy. M39. It's Blue's M39. He gave it to me.
I'm dead.
Blue, you got this.
No, I don't. Wait, someone's opening and closing the gate up there. Monkers.
Is this door open, Stevie?
Shouldn't be.
He's running away.
Oh, nice. Another one just ran right in front of me. I'm dead.
Uh-oh.
Unpoggers! No! I'm dead!
He's 1 HP. Oh, no! Medding, dude. He's right inside base. You can jump down and just DB him right on the side of the
They're
base.
Definitely right, I'm doing more than one.
Running around to the front side. Hey, what happened?
Oh, I see the guy on the hill. I'm 20 HP.
I hate this. Don't rock me, please. He's gonna. No. Oh no. I'm dead to a rock.
Why are they? I think they're getting rockets, man. They're camping hard.
They could try all they want. They could try all they fucking want. You know what's gonna happen? I'm gonna fuck them up.
With what? Zero meds, zero wood, hardly any ammo. Oh no.
Alright, we need to sacrifice for a bit of wood. No joke. Listen, my bag timer's gonna be up. I'm gonna go out. Alright, I F1.
They're out there, man.
They're out there.
I see them.
Give me comfort, Frost.
One guy is here on a horse. One guy just arrived on a horse.
We're fucked.
And he's got a launcher on his back. Alright, I'm F1 killing and spawning inside. I can't kill so quickly. I need one of them to kill me.
It was nice knowing you guys.
Wait. I'm gonna rock him to death. I've seen this in a video before. I'm dead. Okay, good. You killed me.
Have
I wanted
you seen that.
That
in a video?
Alright.
Oh, baby, a triple! I have an idea. They're 8 rocketing the side because they're brain dead?
Yeah, why would they do that?
It'll be more than 8, won't it?
Yeah, because it's armored and sheet metal.
Oh, good thing I remember that. Wait.
Oh my god, it's already open! What?
Oh.
Well, I guess they're pretty smart.
I'm putting a box on our guns, dude. We're good. Wait, how is it already open?
The foundation seemed to be stone. Wait, how is it already open? It would have taken 8, right? Did they use 8 or 4?
It appears that our foundation is missing. I'm gonna break it. I'm ready for them to break TC because I'm gonna place a new one upstairs.
Oh shit, I forgot there's an upstairs.
I'm dead.
Are they at TC?
Yeah, they're at TC. They're breaking TC maybe?
Maybe.
Get ready. I think
they literally just placed it, dude.
Really?
Dude, like right as I was telling Frost where to go, bro.
Oh my god.
No shot.
I'm dead too.
They're still raiding it.
Why is no one countered is the question.
They're still using rockets, dude. They spent like 3 more than they had to.
I think the silver lining is that we used our rockets before.
Yeah.
And therefore they didn't make profit. Even if the rockets were the reason they came over and we got raided in the first place, I'd say worth.
But no, our base was done. There was no miraculous raid defense or anything of the sort. And to continue what I was saying in the intro before Blue cut me off, it was going to be a truly special day. But despite all our attempts at concealing the server we were playing on, eventually, it got compromised. You see, haven't seen it much because I've been trying to keep it out of the footage, but stream snipers had found the server. And the longer the wipe went, the more and more we played, the worse it got. There were nakeds outside of our base, hitting trees, building bases right beside ours. They were leaving us notes. There were people literally outside saying that Frost, Blueprint, and Stevie are inside this base. I mean, there was even a group of guys on the server that ran over to our base in full metal kits and let us kill them. We despawned all of their guns and gear on the second story. We weren't going to use any of it. But that shows you really all of the ways an adventure can be ruined by stream sniping. We were trying our best to get these people banned because stream sniping is a bannable offense on this server, but faster than we were working with the admins to ban stream snipers, more were flocking to our base. Could that have swayed the raiders' opinions on whether or not to actually raid our base to begin with? We don't know. Now, I am not saying at all that I think the raiding party was stream sniping. We really didn't think they were. But there were definitely a ton of people outside of our base that were doing it. And because of that, the adventure was no longer genuine. Like Blueprint had feared at the beginning of the day, the server was now compromised. Under normal circumstances, we would restart after we got raided. We would keep playing. We would get revenge. But because of these circumstances, this go around, we didn't. We hopped over on a private server. There was a big manhunt event that Frost hosted that we played for the next several hours, and it was a ton of fun. The day was a lot of fun, despite it ending with us getting raided. We'd each made big plays to get the snowball rolling faster and faster. We had had a bunch of laughs. Memories had definitely been made. But, like I said earlier, Blueprint and Frost frequently stream rust. They are used to servers getting compromised, to adventures being cut short by stream sniping. I was not. As I looked at all of the raiders running around our base, I realized there was something missing from this adventure. Because of how it ended, I didn't really find satisfaction. And because of that, right then and there, I decided that my time on this server, this wipe, was not yet finished. Although Blue would go on to continue editing his upcoming video and Frost would continue to stream over the next few days, I was gonna keep playing on that server. And at the time, I don't know what I expected. But what my Rust adventure would entail over the next few days was incredible. Probably one of the best wipes I have ever played in my thousands and thousands of hours playing Rust. This day, July 9th, the day the Kings came together despite all of its fun, was just the tip of the iceberg. And so here, we'll put our story on pause. And although I hate leaving you on a cliffhanger like this, I can promise you, whatever the wait ends up being for my next video, it will be worth it. And so, it's goodbye until next time. My name is Stevie. Thank you so much for watching. I know sorrow, I know pain. Let them have me if I'm ready.